So millions of friendly bacteria live in our intestines, and they're very important for various aspects of gut health, including things like digestion, motility. But when your microbiome becomes unbalanced, regardless of the reason, it can cause things like diarrhea and cramping and bloating. And this is where taking specific probiotics and certain strains of probiotics can really help turn this microbiome around, and this in turn can help stop your diarrhea. Well, hey there, I'm Dr. Hagmeyer, and if you find that you have to rush to the bathroom regularly or you're planning your day around the nearest washroom, like many people with irritable bowel syndrome or inflammatory bowel disease or small intestinal bacterial overgrowth, stay tuned because in this video, I'm going to review some of the best probiotics and the best probiotic strains to use when you're suffering with chronic diarrhea. Now, one thing I'm going to say is that if you're watching this on YouTube, there's going to be a lot of different names of specific strains of probiotics that you've probably never heard of before. And so I suggest either you pause this video and you grab something that you can write on, or otherwise check out the description box where I'm going to leave a link to this video where there'll be a video transcript that shows up on my website. So you can actually go back and review that as well. Keep in mind this though, as we learn more about probiotics, we're learning how specific strains have specific purposes. What are probiotics, right? And just as a quick reminder, probiotics are made of good live bacteria and yeast that naturally live in our body. In our intestines, we have three categories of bacteria, like I like to think about it. We have good bacteria, we have bad bacteria, and we have bacteria that are called opportunistic bacteria. And these are bacteria that really can be good or bad depending on the circumstance. Now, when you get an infection, there's more bad bacteria and opportunistic bacteria that are knocking your system out of balance, right? And good bacteria help eliminate bad bacteria, and they help reestablish and return that balance. Well, probiotic supplements are one of the most effective ways to add good bacteria back into the body, and by doing so, you can help reset your microbiome to some extent. Now, some probiotics obviously help us digest food. Others destroy disease-causing cells. Some help our bodies produce certain vitamins, like B vitamins and vitamin K. Other bacteria are responsible for making things like neurotransmitters and short-chain fatty acids, things that can affect our mental health, the connection between brain and gut. Well, the best type of probiotics for treating diarrhea, and if you're like most people looking to purchase a probiotic for diarrhea, it obviously can become a dizzying, a dizzying event. When you look at all the different kinds of probiotic strains and different formulations for different probiotics. But the thing is this, research shows that supplementing with a select few is the most beneficial when combating diarrhea. So here's what you need to look for when it comes to probiotics and probiotic strains for diarrhea. Number one on my list is Saccharomyces. Now, Saccharomyces boulardii is actually not a bacteria. Instead, it's a beneficial yeast. And it's probably one of the most studied probiotics when it comes to treating diarrhea. That's either caused by antibiotics or by an infection that's picked up when people often travel and drink local water. Now, Saccharomyces boulardii has a number of positive effects on the gut outside of just treating diarrhea. A very common infection seen in people who have acid reflux or heartburn, they're often infected with a bacterium called H. pylori. Well, H. pylori can cause indigestion, stomach ulcers, and even stomach cancer. Well, a look at data from 18 trials, almost looking at 3,600 people on the use of Saccharomyces boulardii, found that Saccharomyces boulardii is very beneficial in treating this infection. They also went on to say that the conclusion study was that supplementation significantly increased H. pylori eradication rates and reduced the total incidence of side effects caused by antibiotics. The other thing Saccharomyces helps do is it helps improve the brush border enzymes. These are enzymes that help us break down proteins and sugars in our diet. If your brush border enzymes don't do the job, you end up with severe malabsorption of nutrients that lead to weight loss. Saccharomyces boulardii produces short-chain fatty acids such as butyrate and acetate, and these help support and nourish the colonic mucosa. Saccharomyces boulardii enhances the number of healthy bifidobacterium in the colon, and these type of bacteria are able to keep Clostridia in check. We also know that Saccharomyces boulardii helps with leaky gut, and that in turn helps with chronic diarrhea. It's also been shown to dampen down the inflammatory response in the gut. So this is something I use very often in my practice with patients. Number two on my list of probiotics for diarrhea is Lactobacillus rhamnosus GG. It's a mouthful. But Lactobacillus rhamnosus GG is another very effective probiotic for treating diarrhea in both adults and in children. Lactobacillus rhamnosus has also been studied when someone has diarrhea that's caused by rotavirus. Now, rotavirus is a very highly contagious virus that can spread when your unclean hands touch feces and then you touch or scratch or itch or rub your nose or your mouth. But just to be clear, you don't have to have rotavirus in order to take Lactobacillus rhamnosus GG. Lactobacillus rhamnosus is a transient Lactobacillus species, and it colonizes the small intestines when it's consumed on a regular basis. It favorably enhances the innate and acquired immunity. It helps improve CD4 counts for those people with mold and Lyme disease. So it does a lot of different things as far as our immune system goes and natural killer cells and inflammatory cytokines in our gut. The other thing is that when we consider these probiotics, the results go and extend beyond just our gut, okay? Number three on my list is Lactobacillus casei, right? Now, the great thing about Lactobacillus casei is that it produces lactic acid in the gut. Now, lactic acid lowers the pH in the gut, and this makes it an unfriendly environment for bacteria that cause diarrhea. Lowering the pH also helps with the absorption of nutrients. Lactic acid also has antimicrobial ability, which means that it can fight off gram-negative and gram-positive bacteria. The benefits of this strain is that it also treats diarrhea. Now, the next couple of probiotics belong to the bifidobacterium family. The first family, or the first strain I want to mention here, is Bifidobacterium lactis. Again, this probiotic strain has been shown to reduce the severity and frequency of diarrhea in adults and in children. Bifidobacterium lactis can play a significant role in combating allergies, eczema, assisting with high cholesterol, breaking down waste metabolites. It can help with blood sugar problems. It can decrease the toxic effects of gluten, which we know is very, very damaging to the intestinal lining. It's also been shown to help with a leaky gut. Now, another strain belonging to this Bifidobacterium family that you should know about when it comes to diarrhea are Bifidobacterium bifidum and Bifidobacterium brevi. Now, these bacteria are two types of commensal bacteria, meaning that they should be a part of a healthy microbiome. Unfortunately, most of us have taken antibiotics in our lifetime, and those antibiotics really just wipe out these guys in our gut. When you supplement with Bifidobacterium brevi and Bifidobacterium species, you're essentially inoculating your gut with these good bacteria, and you're replenishing what's been lost from using antibiotics. Now, Bifidobacterium brevi and Bifidobacterium lactis suppress overgrowth of disease-causing bacteria. These are called pathogenic microbes. And again, very, very effective at conditions like candida and C. diff. So there you go. If you're struggling with diarrhea, the probiotics that I reviewed during today's video are some of the most important, most widely studied strains of probiotics that have shown clinical effectiveness. While there's a lot more that can be done just from a standpoint of improving gut health and improving the gut microbiome above and beyond just probiotics, these supplements will at least give you some direction on what to look for the next time you go to purchase probiotics for your diarrhea. Now, if you're someone out there and you're watching this video and you feel like you've hit a brick wall with your diarrhea and you're discouraged with your lack of improvement, reach out to my clinic. Visit my website, and once you're there, click on the button that says Become a Patient. Now, if you like today's video, after you give it a thumbs up, drop me a comment below or a question below, and again, I'll do my best to answer that. There's another video that I think you might be interested in, and you can check that somewhere up here somewhere.